belief. Leaning on Mother Tree, I said to myself, we all lost touch. Your favorite fruit is chocolate covered cherries and seedless watermelon.
Using light and heat gradients, we set up a control where we filled a tube with brine shrimp and attached clamps at 25, 50 and 75 centimeters. We let it sit for 20 minutes, allowing the shrimp to go to their respective realized niche. We also set up two experimental test tubes. One experimental tube sat halfway under a heat lamp, covered in black tape, and stood for 30 minutes. The second experimental tube, half covered in black tape, sat under a light which shined through a beaker of water in order to avoid emitted heat. After 30 minutes, we tightened screw clamps on each tube to prevent organisms from traveling between sections. Each section was poured into a separate labeled beaker, enabling us to count the number of brine shrimp that occupied each section. We also took the temperature of the water in the experimental tube, reacting to the heat gradient.
Anyway, like I was saying, shrimp is the fruit of the sea. You can barbecue it, boil it, broil it, bake it, saute it. There's shrimp kebabs, shrimp creole, shrimp gumbo, pan fried, deep fried, stir fried. There's pineapple shrimp, lemon shrimp, coconut shrimp, pepper shrimp,
shrimp soup, shrimp stew, shrimp salad, shrimp and potatoes, shrimp burger, shrimp sandwich. That's about it.
In this lab, after testing different selective pressures of brine shrimp, we were able to determine how the shrimp reacted to their fundamental and realized niche. The selective pressures used in this lab included light and temperature gradients. Analyzing the shrimp's behavioral responses to the applied light and temperature stimuli enabled us to define species characteristics and evaluate their fitness. Our results concluded that the majority of brine shrimp were better adapted to cooler temperatures and darker light. A shrimp's natural niche involves many other selective pressures that may vary results.